published 1712 Eastern Standard Time, the 6th of March 2018, updated 2151 Eastern Standard Time, the 6th of March 2018. Real Madrid needed to progress to save their season and left the Parc des Princes with exactly what they came for after comfortably beating PSG. Cristiano Ronaldo's headed effort and a deflected strike from Casemiro, sandwiched in between a close-range strike from Edinson Cavani, meant Zidane's side comfortably triumphed 5-2 across the two legs. Here, Sportsmail brings you a roundup of all the things you may have missed from Tuesday's Champions League action. Real Madrid celebrate as they go through to the quarterfinals after beating PSG 2-1 on Tuesday. PSG may have missed their chance to embarrass Real Madrid on Tuesday night, but their fans haven't forgotten about how the Parisian outfit inflicted one of the worst defeats in the history of Los Blancos some 25 years ago. Fans were seen displaying a banner which read, 25 ANS plus TARD. Our entrez vous aussi dans l'histoire, which translates as, 25 years later, write yourself into the history books too, relating to one of Real Madrid's most forgettable European nights ever. The banner refers to second leg of the UEFA Cup quarterfinal in 1993. PSG overturned a 3-1 loss at the Bernabeu to beat Real Madrid 4-1 in the second leg, a defeat which is viewed as one of the worst in Madrid's history, who were expected to win comfortably but fell to an expensively assembled team that featured George Weah and David Ginola.
A PSG banner displayed translates to, 25 years later, write yourself into the history books too. Great banner at
25 years later, write yourself into the history books too. pic.twitter.com/paxt3wpcw, Daniel Matthews, @_DanMatthews_, March 6, 2018. When PSG famously downed the Spanish Giants in 1993, the Parc des Princes donned a smoky atmosphere as fans lit flares and did all they could to unsettle Madrid, a tactic PSG fans also repeated some 25 years later. In the early stages of the match, a notable haze filled the stadium, created by the many flares around the ground. The smoky atmosphere covered all corners of the ground in attempt to unsettle the visitors, building off the work of PSG ultras, who banged drums and let off flares outside Real Madrid's team hotel at 1:30 a.m. to wake up the Madrid players on Monday night. The fog again appeared at the start of the second half, as the ultras embarked on a similar pattern of lighting flares, but all attempts to ruin the groove of the reigning champions proved fruitless. Cristiano Ronaldo looks on as smoke fills the background due to flares from fans in Paris. The PSG fans set off flares as a tactic to unsettle the Real Madrid players on the pitch. One stand at the Parc des Princes is lit up with red flares as PSG play Real Madrid on Tuesday. Cristiano Ronaldo can consider himself lucky that he wasn't sent off in the first half for taking a swipe at a former Barcelona fullback. As Madrid were awarded a free kick, Dani Alves raced ahead of the Portuguese forward and in response, Ronaldo tried to kick him. The kick itself didn't appear malicious or come across as Ronaldo attempting to go out of his way to hurt Alves, but had the Brazilian received contact, it would have been tough to make an argument against sending Ronaldo off. The referee failed to spot it and the Champions League's all-time record goalscorer ended up completing the full 90 minutes. PSG right-back Dani Alves pushes past Cristiano Ronaldo after being in an offside position. The Brazilian grabs Ronaldo's arm and moves the Real Madrid man out of his way. The Portuguese talisman swings his leg in an attempt to kick Alves but fails to make contact. David Beckham returned to the club he ended his career with as they failed to find a way past the side which famously made him a Galactico over a decade ago. Beckham, who retired as a PSG player back in 2013, was back in Paris to watch his two former sides in the stands. Florentino Perez began his tenure as president of Real Madrid by signing at least one Galactico per summer, and Beckham was 2003 superstar addition, joining the Spaniards from Manchester United for a fee of £24.5 million. The former England captain won league titles with both clubs and was joined by another old teammate with a huge trophy cabinet in Gary Neville, who joined Bex in the stands and appeared to be in good spirits throughout. Supermodel Bella Hadid and Germany manager Joachim Löw were also in attendance. David Beckham and former Manchester United teammate Gary Neville watch from the stands. The former PSG midfielder takes a picture on his phone during the Real Madrid game. Real Madrid president Florentino Perez greets his former Galactico at the Parc des Princes. Supermodel Bella Hadid was also in attendance during Tuesday night's game in Paris. Fan news broke that Neymar had broken his foot and faces a race to be fit for the World Cup. To some, that was the moment that PSG's chances of progress against Real Madrid ended, but the Brazilian superstar remained optimistic. Alemon Gars was the message Neymar posted to his Instagram story from the sunny climes of Belo Horizonte, Brazil, where he is currently based as he recovers from surgery on his fifth metatarsal in his right foot. An injured Neymar had to watch the game from the comfort on his bed back home in Brazil. If there was an option to pick a fantasy football team of Champions League players, Cristiano Ronaldo would be a pretty safe bet. His goal against PSG means he has now scored in 9 consecutive games in Europe, but what's even more remarkable is that he's bagged 14 strikes in that time. Ronaldo joins Ruud van Nistelrooy as the second player in the competition's history to score in 9 straight, as the Dutchman also repeated the feat in 2003, scoring 12 times along the way. Cristiano Ronaldo broke the deadlock with his head to give Real Madrid the advantage. The goal means Ronaldo equaled a record, scoring in 9 straight Champions League games.